I'm Belle Gersmeyer. I'm a senior at Maine West High School.
Hi, I'm Jimmy Cohn, and I'm a senior at Maine South High School.
Hi, I'm Daniel Cho. I'm a junior at Maine East High School.
And we're your hosts for tonight's Maine 207 Foundation Benefit.
Welcome to tonight's program. We're so excited you could be here with us.
Sorry we're not in person, but like so much in this crazy year, we've had to adapt.
Tonight's benefit is for such a good cause.
You know, until recently, I didn't know much about the Maine 207 Foundation. But then I learned about all the amazing things it does.
Let's first hear from the Foundation's chair, Susan Yegard.
Good evening, and welcome to the Maine 207 Foundation's 2021 benefit. On behalf of the entire Board of Trustees, thank you for joining us tonight to learn about how the Foundation continues to support the students, staff, and families of District 207, even during the most challenging of times. Throughout the years, the foundation has awarded over $200,000 in teacher and student grants. We support a wide range of programs, from guest lecturers who visit a few classrooms to programs that reach the district at large. Our accomplishments, however, are only possible due to your generosity. So thank you to all of you who have already made a donation, and to those of you who still would like to donate, you may visit our website at any time. Now, let's get on with the program. I'm happy to turn it back over to our three very talented student MCs who will guide you through tonight's benefit.
Wow, $200,000 in grants. That is a lot of money.
Yeah, the foundation helps students and teachers do things that the school budget doesn't cover.
Some grants are permanent, like the Mosaic in Maine West High School.
Others, like guest speakers, field trips, and competitions, are one-time events.
But they make a lasting impact on the students who participate.
Tonight, we'll learn what the foundation makes possible.
And how it impacts all of us students in District 207.
Inspired by the construction going on at our schools, the theme of tonight's benefit is Building for Tomorrow. And our host committee is the Hard Hats. Let's see who they are.
This group has already raised over $30,000 for the foundation. They're made up of alumni, past and current parents, administrators, faculty members, and even the 207 Education Association. Thanks to the Hard Hats and everyone else who has donated already.
You can donate at any time by going to the website. And don't forget, if you pre-purchased raffle tickets, we're going to be announcing those at the end of the night. So stay tuned.
To get us in the spirit for tonight, some of our classmates want to share a musical performance that really shows how we're thinking about the future.
Here is the Maine Township Chamber Choir singing A Million Dreams from The Greatest Showman.
I close my eyes and I can see a world that's waiting up for me that I call my own.
Through the dark, through the door, through where no one's been before, but it feels like home.
They can say it all sounds crazy. They can say I've lost my mind. I don't care, so call me crazy. We can live in a world that we design. 'Cause every night I lie in bed, the brightest colors fill my head. A million dreams are keeping me awake. I think of what
That was so beautiful, and put together on Zoom.
When this is all over, I'll be so glad to be done with Zoom.
Yeah, that has really been part of the COVID reality this year.
Speaking of COVID, District 207 and the Foundation really stepped up to help us here. So far, they've raised over $100,000 in the COVID Emergency Fund to help District 207 families. Take a look at the impact the COVID Emergency Fund has had on families.
We are delivering gift cards to students and families that are in need as a result of the pandemic that's happened.
From Jewel, from Walmart, Aldi, Tony's. Now I got my Target gift cards for my families. So that's what I was here
for. For the first round, we have about 140 families that we've identified, and there are obviously a lot of other families out there that we don't even know about right now. A lot of our families within the district are already living paycheck to paycheck. Now with the crisis, so many of our families are now out of work or their source of income has stopped. And now they're not living paycheck to paycheck anymore. They're just living on what they have. And just this little bit of a gift card can help a family survive and buy food for the week.
There are families that were already struggling, maybe to put food on the table or to have some of those basic household items, would probably struggle even more in the coming weeks. So as soon as we started planning for e-learning, it became very apparent that we also needed to plan to make sure that our students all had their basic needs met. Each of our families are in different circumstances, and we definitely have a common goal to serve those families the very best that we can. We're very, very lucky that the area surrounding all three of our schools are also very generous.
I love being able to help our students and help our families and knowing that we can provide them what they need to get by.
Many of them work in jobs that would not allow them to work from home, of course, if you are in the service industry. And they have either been laid off or they have lost their jobs.
We had a mother reach out to us who has seven children. Some of the children are adult children, but all living at home. Everybody in the family has lost their job or been laid off as a result of the pandemic. And now they're struggling to get by every day just with basic needs.
And see how thankful they are for the little things that we are giving them. This is not a lot. And they are so grateful. And that gratitude reminds me of that many of us are in very secure places, but that a lot of our families are not.
That fund sure helped a lot of families. And you know, even when we're not in a pandemic, we still need to all support each other to be healthy.
The school-based health clinic really helps with this.
That's another great resource the Maine 207 Foundation has supported for years.
To tell us more about the work of the clinic, let's go to Amy Carlson at the School-Based Health Center.
The clinic is available for any student in District 207. We're a fully functioning clinic, so we provide both medical and mental health services, preventative care, physicals, asthma checks, all of their immunizations here at no cost for anyone that has no insurance or it has state insurance. And then we also have 32 hours worth of mental health services.
The School-Based Health Center is this amazing collaborative between the school district and Advocate Healthcare to provide health, preventative, and treatment to our students. I love working here because I feel like we can really empower the students to take ownership of their health.
There's so many things we can do here that in a big health system you can't do, and we can really get to know our patients, we can take our time with the patients.
I work right across the street at Lutheran General, and these same kids are not going there. There's barriers that prevent students from really accessing healthcare when they need it. So I think this type of an environment really helps to break those barriers down and allow kids to be coming in.
If I were ever sick, I would always come here because it was almost like I treated the school-based health center as my primary care area. And I think my siblings felt the same. It almost gave me like the autonomy, or like it was my responsibility to take care of my own care. They would understand me more because they interact with my age group. So as a fourth year medical student, you're normally doing blocks of 4 weeks, kind of rotating through different clinic or hospital sites.
Deep breath in and out.
I help groom them, and then I go and I actually take their history, and then I'm performing physical exams.
Now with our COVID pandemic, we've had to pivot figuring out how to provide COVID testing.
To be able to test free of charge and to get it done right here, I think has been a big relief for a lot of families and staff. We've probably done 500 or more. The Maine 207 Foundation helps us by providing financial assistance for staffing support, for supplies in the clinic, to help maintain the basic running of this clinic. It's a collaboration between donations and then a state grant that really helps run this clinic, so we're super thankful.
The members of the foundation and from the district to help the students is incredible, and I think that's really what keeps this clinic going.
Not too long ago, District 207 said farewell to a true community builder and friend, Joyce Christensen. Joyce was instrumental in the formation of the school-based health center and served on its advisory board until her death.
Joyce and her husband Bob were married for over 67 years, and they raised their family in the district with a son and daughter who graduated from Maine East.
Joyce spent her professional career directing Maine Township special education programs, where she worked as a champion for students with special needs.
She also fought to implement the Thorgood Tornado Warning System, and she served as the first woman president of the Park Ridge Rotary.
Joyce was one of the original founders of the Maine 207 Foundation, even serving as its first secretary. We're so thankful for the dedication of Joyce to the district and the Maine 207 Foundation. She will truly be missed.
What an inspiration and example for us all.
Remember, you can support the Education Foundation too by visiting the website and making a contribution.
You can choose to help continue Joyce's work by making a direct donation to the school-based health center.
Let's take a look at how the foundation supports programs that engage the community outside of schools.
Through these programs, students see what their futures can look like by learning from and engaging with a variety of community members, including alumni.
A great example was the Latino Summit that was organized by Maine West and involved all three schools. It celebrates the diversity in our district and addresses the issues impacting our Latino community. Here is Dr. Rueda Alvarez to tell us more about it.
The Latino Summit is an event. It's a yearly event we created to bring together Latino students, freshmen and sophomores from all of our Northwest suburb community, have them dream big, inspire them to continue with their education after high school. And show them the role model, bringing current college students and current professionals in more than 60 different sectors who are Latino to talk to them about how they made it, how they were able to make that a reality. And we're hoping that by seeing those role models and by seeing themselves in them, that will serve an inspiration for them to achieve their dreams and go beyond high school and become what they have the potential to become.
Everyone there like is a Latino or Latina, and you just feel very included. To me, it's mainly inspiring, a way to see that like I could do it as well, or like my family could do it as well. I plan to attend a four-year college or university to go into nursing. And I think right now we're in such a major need right now for that help.
We wanted to bring all the students together under one roof because we have heard over and over again people talking about the achievement of Latino students. They're not graduating, they're not going to college, what are we going to do about it? And I wondered what would happen if we were to bring everybody together and then tell you about that. And then also showcasing our talent, the professionals, so we could have this message of hope that yes, we can all do it. Que sí se puede. Where there is a will, there is a way. Always. You don't get because of your degrees or because of your money. No, it's ganas, mis amores. It's how much you put in is what you get out. It's been a privilege to serve you. It's been a privilege to speak with you today. And si se puede. Thank you very, very much.
Latino Summit has always been an in-person event. It has taken place in Harper College, and it's been fantastic because we then can have music and food and t-shirts, and the kids don't pay for anything. Due to the pandemic, we cannot have it as an in-person event. Silver lining is that now we don't have to limit the number of students that can attend. Now it is open to any freshman or sophomore that wants to log in and register for the event. The foundation has been providing help and funds for us to make this a reality, a major supporter for us throughout the year.
The foundation has long supported the enhancement of educational opportunities, including service trips. One such example of this is the Lyceum program in Maine East. Here's Mr. Roos to talk more about it.
Give the Lyceum is a program for students who are academically gifted and talented. There's usually about 25 or so students who are in the program every year. And over the course of 4 years, we work with them to develop skills around ethics and argument and understanding themselves, understanding their community, with the idea that as they grow through their 4 years here at Maine East High School, we want them to think of themselves not just as scholars, but also students who have the ability to give back to their community. Traditionally, we have gone every summer on a service trip to help serve communities in need. In the last couple of years, we've gone to Michigan, to Detroit, to Steubenville, Ohio. We go on these trips both to get a deeper experience with working for a longer period of time in giving, and also to help grow the connections between the people in the program. And every year, we ask for a grant from the foundation to help fund that. And every year, the foundation has been generous enough to help us. They've really helped facilitate growing this program and growing these students to be the best that they could be. And so without them, we wouldn't be able to have accomplished everything that we have. It's been very gratifying this year to work with students that I worked with as freshmen a couple years ago and see them really be the better versions of themselves that I was hoping they would be.
He really helped us adjust, and then now it's like full circle where we have him as we're leaving high school. He has really helped us have a strong start during this pandemic and try to get as much work we can do in the community done.
We have two organizations every year that we work with. This year, those organizations are very local. We're working with the school-based health center, and we're working to try and green Maine Township by focusing on in-school composting and other things like that. Students develop their proposals, they pitch them to a board, and then they choose what it is that they're going to work on. It's about being passionate, and it's about trying to work to fulfill that passion, but most importantly, it's about understanding how to work together in order to achieve more.
We can at least take that much time to give back to our community because our community has given so much to us. And service is actually fun and also very self-fulfilling, like you feel great after.
I think it's helped me in a lot of ways with like working in the real world. I feel like I can like do stuff outside of school. It's very good at like helping you figure out who you are and your place in like a community and a school. And I think that's really valuable.
We really try and give them the space to figure out what it is that they want to do and then to start to explore what after high school looks like to work in that space.
Really about self-reflection, and I think right now it's really hard to do that on your own. So when there's someone pushing you to be your best self and just think about it and also do better for the community, I think that's really nice. And so Lyceum has really helped us find a role within our community and understand how we can use our strengths as students to contribute to our community. And Ms. Tyler and Mr. Roos are just like some of the most energetic and most giving people, and so they're the best role models that we could possibly have for Lyceum.
You know, we sure do hear and read a lot about the Constitution these days, not just in the classroom. There's a great program that the Foundation supports that is focused on the Constitution. The C-Team has made it to Nationals many times, and the Foundation provides financial assistance so that they can go to DC. Let's hear more about it from Mr. Trankel.
C-Team, it's a national competition run by the Center for Civic Education that basically asks students to articulate and defend their answers to controversial questions on various aspects of constitutional law that the students have to research, work together as a team, defend a position, and then kind of have that cool kind of competition side of it that I think makes people learn the most. But I think it speaks to kind of the emphasis that District 207 has always put on government. I think a lot of our success speaks to that. The Foundation in many ways are our biggest supporter financially. So they're a big benefit. We're very grateful for that there's this kind of legacy to it that makes it more special.
Competitions take place within courthouses, or we usually go to Washington, D.C. for nationals. So we've been virtual, so that's definitely been a bummer, but we've adapted well.
It's definitely a more different class than anything I've been in. It kind of feels just like going to a place where you're just having a big conversation the whole time, and it's kind of a lot of other people's ideas all blending together, and you kind of just have to start thinking for yourself, and it kind of makes you think for yourself.
I know this year being a part of C-Team has really been the reason why I decided to major in political science. I have just grown a huge passion for political science, being a part of C-Team, and C-Team has just been an experience unlike anything else. You know, winning state was always a good feeling. Our judges were coming out of left field with very difficult questions and, you know, having to adapt. So that was very intimidating going into state, but when we pulled out the win, it was very exciting, and I think it really united us as a team.
The Foundation has helped other teams and individuals compete on the state and national level. DECA, National History Fair, Mock Trial, and the Robotics Team, to name a few.
Wow, these are all great programs.
Remember, they all depend on support from our neighbors and friends, like all of you joining us tonight.
If you have not already, please consider going to the website and making a donation.
Our schools depend on committed families, teachers, and administrators.
And tonight, we would like to recognize one of our extraordinary leaders.
Here again is Susan Yegard, chair of the Maine 207 Foundation.
It is with great pleasure and gratitude that the Maine 207 Foundation awards to Eldon Burke its 25-year service award. This award honors him for his commitment to the foundation and its mission. But his service goes back even farther to his 32 years as a science teacher, a student council advisor, a coach, a dean, and an assistant principal at Maine West, as well as his time on the District 207 School Board. Clearly, Eldon's devotion to our community, our school district, and our students is unparalleled. The trustees value his friendship, his sage advice, and his clear sense of purpose for our foundation. Thank you, Eldon.
I want to thank the foundation so much for this award of 25 years of service. It's been a pleasure for me to serve in this capacity. I think one of the best decisions I ever made in my professional life was coming to District 207 and Maine West High School in 1963, having been able to continue to serve the community and the district and the school after retirement has been a blessing for me as well. I've always had the feeling that we need to leave more than we take as we leave this world, and I've had the opportunity to make contributions through my work here at District 207. I've really enjoyed the work with the foundation, school-based health center, and many other opportunities in the community. So thank you very much for this opportunity. I appreciate it.
And thank you to all of you tonight who have joined us in celebrating the Maine 207 Foundation and its continued mission of supporting student well-being and innovative educational opportunities for the students of District 207.
This has been a really fun and informative evening.
With your help, the Foundation will be there to support us, the students of Maine East,
Maine South,
and Maine West, as we build our tomorrows.
Thank you again to the Hard Hat Host Committee and the sponsors for this year's benefit.
To find out if you're one of the lucky raffle winners, you may now go to the Foundation's website.
So needless to say, odds and ends, oh, I'll be stumbling away. So learning the love is a play. Say after me.
Take on me.